Also, Woot had to tell his story, which was very simple and did not take long. The giantess laughed heartily when the boy related their adventure at Loonville, but said she knew nothing of the loons because she never left her valley.
"There are wicked people who would like to capture me, as they did my giant husband, Mr. Youp,"
said she.
"So I stay at home and mind my own business."
"If Ozma knew that you dared to work magic without her consent, she would punish you severely," declared the Scarecrow. "For this castle is in the Land of Oz, and no persons in the Land of Oz are permitted to work magic except Glinda the Good and the little wizard who lives with Ozma in the Emerald City."
"That for your Ozma!"
exclaimed the giantess, snapping her fingers in derision.
"What do I care for a girl whom I have never seen, and who has never seen me?"
"But Ozma is a fairy," said the Tin Woodman, "and therefore she is very powerful. Also, we are under Ozma's protection, and to injure us in any way would make her extremely angry."
"What I do here in my private castle in this secluded valley, where no one comes but fools like you, can never be known to your fairy Ozma,"
returned the giantess.
"Do not seek to frighten me from my purpose, and do not allow yourselves to be frightened, for it is best to meet bravely what cannot be avoided. I am now going to bed, and in the morning I will give you all new forms, such as will be more interesting to me than the ones you now wear. Good night and pleasant dreams."